I was asked about how the MacBook performs under load with a big session using the endurance app for low power mode. Honestly, I don't do a lot of big sessions, so I don't know if I'm the best person to test this. I mostly do like kind of like down tempo stuff and that indie rock, just kind of producing for myself. So, but I tried to kind of mimic up a load test so we could see how this thing performs. And basically, I was able to get 20 instances of Serum to run in Studio One when the endurance app was not in low power mode, and I was seeing that meeting the threshold of what could be run in Studio One as far as CPU performance. It was interesting that, and I'll show you this, but it was interesting that I saw the CPU performance spiking in Studio One, but the CPU performance in Activity Monitor was actually still pretty low. So I think there is something with how Studio One or something about how Serum interacts with the CPU that causes it to spike within Studio One. And I'm not really well versed in how to make this more efficient, but I'm sure that there are people out there that are. And if anybody knows how, I would be really interested to learn how. But let me show you this test here. So this is just a simple chord progression. I'll show you here in the first one. So not really much going on in the progression, but with all these instances of Serum running, you'll start to see some spikes in performance. So if I open up the performance monitor in Studio One, so this is Studio One's performance monitor, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna mute this so that we don't need to actually hear this going the whole time. But I will hit play here, and we're gonna keep an eye on that power gadget here, because you'll see kind of what this project is asking for in terms of CPU as I play this and as I start enabling more instances of Serum here. Watch this CPU monitor here for Studio One as I start to enable these. It performs pretty well for the first maybe 15 instances of Serum. And then we start to see some spikes. Again, this is nothing. I would never have this personally for what I do with music. I would never have this many instances of Serum or anything other powerful instruments. And if I did, I would probably print a track at some point. But I know there was a question because some people have large sessions and maybe do orchestral music where they need more stuff. What's interesting about this to me is, we see the CPU spike occasionally here. It's spiking now. It's really spiking now. If I put 20 on, you'll see within Studio One, you'll see this spike. But if you look at the activity monitor, max activity monitor shows, very low CPU load. So again, I think there's something with how Studio One manages CPU processing or how Serum manages it. And I'm not the technical guy to answer that, but this is, again, just a demo to show some of this stuff. But this is in regular power mode, so endurance is not in low power mode. You can probably start to hear the fans start to ramp up now. So what happens if I think the question was, what would happen, I'm gonna stop this. You see like I think Serum is really power hungry here. So he's asking for a lot of power. We're going into, we're asking for more CPU here. I stopped the song, so everything should start to calm down. And the question was, what happens if you go into low power mode? Does it impact this at all? Well, what I found in my testing was, it didn't impact really, because there was like the throttle seemed to be within Studio One or within Serum as far as hitting the CPU threshold, rather than within the load in the MacBook itself. So let's go back here again. So I'm now in low power mode. In low power mode, here in my settings, slowing down processor is the important one. And if I do this again, so we'll start with just one instance, and I start playing this again. Watch the CPU here. Start adding these in. We'll go a little bit quicker this time so we're not having to wait through all this. So seeing CPUs spike occasionally right at the same spot it was before, right around, you know, 15, 16 instances. If I enable all these, still getting some, you know, we're still getting CPU spikes here, but if what's interesting is like over here, if you look at, you know, low power mode is working. You know, we're not you know, endurance is kind of throttling what we're asking for the CPU, and you know the CPU load is, you know, the cumulative CPU load in the MacBook activity monitor is very similar to what it was before, if not a little bit higher, which is interesting. So this over here was when we didn't have low power mode engaged, and this here is when we did have low power mode engaged. So this is running, you know, with two external monitors like it was before. You know, my setup is basically the same as when I had made the video about, you know, low power mode with endurance fan noise with the external monitor. So again, this is just not very indicative of a track that I would personally record. A track I would personally record, you know, is something more like this. Go let this load for a second. I'll turn. Well, I'll keep low power mode on, and I'll show you the performance on this one. So this is more of basically the amount of tracks that I might have. You know, it's. Not very busy. I'll mute this up. You can see the power performance here. Show devices. So you see all these devices. You know, for what I would consider, for how I, right, normal use, you know, here's what I have. And you can see even within Studio One, the CPU is not really doing much. And I don't, and you know, I'm in low power mode here. If I turn this off, I mean, I don't think it'll change too much. Gives me a little bit more CPU performance within Studio One. You can see power gadgets going up, activity monitor, CPU loads like low. So I don't know that the computer itself has. I think we're reaching limits within Studio One, what you can do with instruments through there, well before we're reaching limits in the computer. So hopefully that's a good enough example. I think that, again, I'm not the most technical guy to be kind of giving this demo. I would be interested to know if people know any more details about how to get more performance out of either the instruments like Serum or out of Studio One, so that we're not hitting the CPU threshold within the DAW, and we can make more use out of all the cores and all the CPU power available to us in this MacBook. So hopefully that helps make an assessment of how this performs under stress, under low power mode and regular power mode. Like I said, I'm not probably the guy to be doing this performance test, but I wanted to get something out there because there was a question about it, and hopefully this gives some insight into how this works. Okay, thanks for watching.